Let's take a look at the best and worst wrestling matches over the past week of pro wrestling. And as always, we start with the worst, and we start with the only bad match at Survivor Series. It should be no surprise, it's Ronda Rousey and Shotzi. Ronda Rousey continues to be a low point in the WWE right now, and the SmackDown's women division not helping it out. There was some botches in this match.
But Rousey was under the ropes!
And I don't think the build to this match was great anyway, because Ronda on the microphone is a struggle in and of itself. One would think Ronda Rousey tries, but I'm not convinced that she really does. I don't think her mic work shows that she tries. I don't think this match shows that she tries. It was not that good of a match, and definitely the low point of an otherwise great Survivor Series. At number two, worst matches of the week, we move over to AEW's women's division, and another match that shows why AEW's women's division is also a struggle. They just kind of throw things together with no consistency, and that's what we got out of the three-team tag match between Tay Mello and Anna Jay versus Hayter and Baker versus Nightingale and Sky Blue. This was a cluster of a match. I think it was all over the place. Sure, it was just used to kind of get the new champion over, Jamie Hayter and Britt Baker winning the match, but the match itself was a mess. And speaking of messes, the worst match of the week has to be Death Triangle versus the Elite in match two of their best of seven trio match series. First of all, only the most diehard fans want to see the best of seven series of trio matches. But then, this entire match was just dedicated to the Elite mocking CM Punk. The biting from Omega, the falling when you try and do the buckshot lariat. It was all to throw shade at CM Punk because of all the backstage problems going on between Punk and the Elite, and Punk seemingly eventually going to be gone from AEW. Now, if the end game is for CM Punk to return and that him to be able to work with the Elite, it would actually probably be the biggest story in wrestling when that happens. But if that is not the end game, and at this point it doesn't seem like the end game, then it's just making this match mean nothing. It makes the trio titles look like a joke, and nobody outside of the smallest portion of the audience wants to see the best of seven trio match series. So this match was the worst of the week in my opinion, because it was a waste of time. Unless the end game is a CM Punk return to feud with the Elite, it's a waste of time. The best matches of the week at number five was Wesley versus Carmelo Hayes for the North American title on NXT. I thought that they continued to build this match well and build Wesley as the new North American champion. The match itself told a fairly basic story where Carmelo Hayes is the cocky heel who is dominating a portion of the match. But in the end, of course, the face, Wesley, gets the best of Carmelo Hayes to prove himself as the new North American champion.
Boom! Wee-wee for the finishing touches, into the cover, and the Cardiac Kid overcomes the odds once again. What happened?
At number four was on Dynamite, Ethan Page versus Ricky Starks. These two are truly the future of AEW if played right by AEW. These two both get it. They told a story in the match with Ricky Starks being all taped up, having an injured shoulder and ribs, and Ethan Page working it the entire match. I think that this could have been higher in my rankings this week if not for commentary. Taz and Tony Schiavone on commentary continued to make quips to each other throughout the match, which kind of took away from an otherwise great story instead of actually telling the story of the match, which they're supposed to do as announcers. Taz can be funny, and their quips can be funny, but in matches like this, it takes away from the match. I did not like the commentary on this match, and it's the reason this match is not higher. But Ethan Page and Ricky Starks themselves told a great story in this match with Ethan Page kind of being the relentless heel, and Ricky Starks, this huge injured underdog who wins the match in the end. At number three, the top three are all from Survivor Series. It was a great Survivor Series, in my opinion. The Women's War Games comes in at number three. Some of the haters will try and pick apart some of the botches early in the match, and there was a few small botches, but otherwise the women went out there and gave it their all. I think the main point of the story with this match was at the end with Becky Lynch and Bianca Belair working together to beat up on Damage Control and win the War Games for their team. I thought there was some great spots from Io Sky. Some people pick apart her botch at the beginning, but she had probably the best spot of the match, jumping from on top of the cage.
You are cleared for takeoff.
Io going airborne!
Of course, Becky Lynch is at the end, jumping from the top of the cage as well. Was a great spot. So, a bit spotty of a match from Women's War Games, but still an exciting match. Number two has to be the U.S. Championship match at Survivor Series. Bobby Lashley, Seth Rollins, and Austin Theory went out there and gave a banger on an event where there are two huge gimmick matches, two War Games matches. To go out there and just have a regular triple threat match, these three delivered huge. I think Bobby Lashley was the star of the match. He was able to be his character, his dominant character self. And I think that's another thing that made this match work, is that every wrestler was in character to an extent. I think Seth Rollins and Austin Theory's character right now are actually not as strong as Bobby Lashley's, which is why Bobby Lashley stood out to me. We'll talk about Seth Rollins' as character with the booking video this week. But this match delivered huge. I loved the ending.
Makes the climb to the top. Superplex by Rollins. Here comes the Falcon Arrow. Spear! Theory
falls on Rollins for the pin and becomes the new U.S. champion. But number one has to go to the Men's War Games match because of the story it told. From SmackDown and throughout Survivor Series is the relationship between Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens stronger than Sami Zayn's relationship with the Bloodline? Jey Uso thinking that Sami Zayn might turn on the Bloodline, but throughout this match we saw Sami Zayn always save the Bloodline throughout this match, save Roman Reigns at the end from being pinned by Kevin Owens.
Kevin Owens has Reigns where he wants him! Stunner by Owens! Kevin Owens for the win inside War Games! And Sami Zayn preventing the official from counting to three!
Helps basically sacrifice his old friend Kevin Owens for the Bloodline, giving the Bloodline the win in this match. And at the end, he doesn't only get an embrace from Roman Reigns, but he gets an embrace from Jey Uso and he cements himself as a member of the Bloodline. Great storytelling in this match here.